it's also a quantity of time, because you're about how you can improve the quality of.
You said obsession, it's really. I mean, you cannot make it as a. It's the first step to become a performer. Obsession.
Constant desire. It's in a way unhealthy, but also necessary and. No, it's marvelous, but sometimes I'm happy, yeah.
Like maybe when you were in school, like did you ever experience any kind of a burnout, and like how did you kind of deal with that if you had experienced?
I can say. In my bag here, or in my backpack, I don't know. I have one little book note that I write every time when I overcome burnout. So what did I do? How did I feel? Did I listen maybe some recording? Did I take a rest, go to a walk and stuff? So this is reminding me if I again go to the burnout and I don't know what to do with getting some kind of not inspiration, losing of inspiration, then I open these notes and I remind myself what did I do when it was great. So that's one of ways I'm dealing with it.
Did you ever experience that?
Me?
Singer, she's a singer. You're a singer.
Yeah,
as a singer, hai mai sperimentato la sensazione di perdere la motivazione, di non burnout, di sentirti bruciato, di non sentirti continuare?
La motivazione, io amo la mia carriera, quindi dall'inizio ad adesso il mio senso è cantare, è fare musica per comunicare. Questo per me lo più importante è, noi i cantanti abbiamo un testo da dire, da spremere, quindi non solo l'emozione, sino il significato del messaggio, questo.
So you're saying basically that he never experienced it. That's for him like a mission of life, he has a story to tell. And this message that he brings, his voice allows him to share, is the motivation of his life, is the reason why he's alive. And he never had time to burn out. His time was fully taken.
You all have this, I think we are all obsessed with music and with our arts and trying to communicate it to someone. This is what maybe it would say in my book, history minds. Also because we're working with emotions, we are very vulnerable at the same time doing arts, and at the same time everyone is allowed to criticize us because you have your teachers, you have your audience, and it's very difficult to make a filter, like what do I need to take from this occasion, this critic, this confrontation maybe, what I want to keep for myself, and that you're okay in like having this path always going sometimes up and down and never in a straight up line, but that you're actually never arriving to a point where you say, okay, I'm done. You know? It's going to be a process, and this is it's okay not to be perfect, or it's okay to get a bad review at a point. So it doesn't destroy your
how
do you call it?
Your
passion.
Yeah.
It's a struggle of constant learning. My experience was I was a challenge with myself and my ability to learn. And when you are next to other musicians, I mean, you always feel like there's something wrong with you. There are people that learn things so quickly, you are struggling days and days to memorize a phrase, right? And then each one of us has different talents, you know, like, and I experienced that all my life. I never had time to get the rest off for burnout, because I was always learning. So you learn something, keep learning, and then once you learn to maintain, because you learn something, you memorize, you play it, and then you go on with other repertoire. 6 months later, you forgot, and then you go back, really learn, 6 months later, you forgot it, and then things come back better than before. But it's a constant struggle of learning. Learning usually doesn't burn you if it's you're learning things that you're interested in.
She was the wrong one to ask.
I cannot ask for help. I'm really bad at that. So
there is a very, how to say, simple thing. We are always surrounded by people that are more talented than we are. We are surrounded by people that have more motivation than we have. We are surrounded by people that have more resources and more money than we have. And whose life seems to be easier than ours. So this is something you will find all in your life.
Social media?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's
everything. Yeah. So the only solution for me has been focus on yourself, what you like most, and challenge yourself. Exactly. Commission with yourself. Make the most of yourself. If you focus well on yourself, you will find your space in the business. If you start looking outside of you, like you say, competition, looking at people that could be more talented or better, you get lost. You may change your job.
I mean, what I would add is you don't know what they are going through. I mean, you might look at a pianist or another musician and they play so wonderfully and you're like, oh my god, he's amazing. But you don't know what he's thinking. You might be like, fuck.
Bang, bang.
I know many pianists, they were so talented when I grew up, they were incredible, they could play anything. But then I learned later on in life, they didn't make a career. Their playing was empty.
That's the burnout.
Learn, and you don't struggle to learn a music phrase, your music phrase loses value. If you struggle with that phrase, a week more than that girl, that your phrase will have an intensity, a heart in it, that the audience will feel, and you might find a job. I know pianists from the reverse. They've been so talented, they're so easy, top school grade, and then not going at all. And they can figure out why they cannot study again. Nobody wants them now. Also, the personality. As a musician, you have to be very, very humble. Build bridges, never burn bridges, then something else. But for what you're saying, focus on your, there's something inside you to analyze it.